Buck O'Neill was a legendary baseball player, manager, and ambassador for Negro Leagues Baseball. In fact, if you have heard of the Negro Leagues before today, it probably had a lot to do with Buck O'Neill.
Buck O'Neill showed lots of character. Buck O'Neill didn't only help in baseball, he helped in his community.
When Buck O'Neill was asked about the hardships he faced, he simply replied, "Waste no tears on me. I didn't come along too early. I was right on time."
Buck O'Neill created the Negro League Baseball Museum. He created this because he wanted the other baseball players in the Negro League Baseball to be remembered.
Everyone should know what he did for the Negro Leagues.
The Kansas City Star wrote about Buck O'Neill, saying, "Buck O'Neill was simply one of America's greatest teachers. While not a teacher by trade, his life was an open book used to inspire and motivate others to dream and believe in their dreams. He taught a nation about the unsung heroes of the Negro Leagues and worked passionately to ensure their legacy would never be forgotten."
Satchel Paige played for the Monarchs and 249 other teams. He was such a great pitcher. He was the first Negro League player in the Hall of Fame.
Satchel Paige made a big impact on Negro Leagues baseball. Says the Negro Leagues Baseball Museum, regarded as the nearest thing to a legend that ever came out of the Negro Leagues.
Satchel Paige is an amazing pitcher. The Negro League Baseball Museum says his estimated pitch career was 2,600 games, 300 shutouts, and 55 no-hitters.
Satchel Paige was a wonderful part of the Negro Leagues.
Rube Foster was a pitcher, first baseman, manager, and exclusive owner. He changed the look of Negro League baseball. Rube wanted baseball players that listened. According to the book, We Are the Shits, Rube was a manager and only wanted ball players who would follow all of his instructions. If a ball player did not listen to Rube, he didn't last long. Rube would tell the ball players how to pitch the ball. According to what Kadir Nelson wrote, the pitchers, they got pitching instructions from Rube sitting in the dugout, not from a catcher, which was more common. Rube would always make sure his team was prepared. According to We Are the Ship, Rube's team was always well equipped with clean, new uniforms, bats, and balls. Since Rube changed the look of Negro League Baseball, he got elected into the Negro League Baseball Hall of Fame. The Negro Leagues wouldn't exist without Rube Foster.
Jackie Robinson was a man who could control his anger. He was the one who made it so African Americans could play with the white people in the major leagues. He was a hero of many for breaking the color barrier.
Jackie could keep his cool, so he got signed to the Dodgers. According to Kadir Nelson from We Are the Ship, before Jackie Robinson signed the major leagues, the team owner Branch Rickey wanted to meet Jackie face to face, and Rickey was screaming every racial epithet in the book, but Jackie kept his cool.
Jackie Robinson made a difference in baseball and in civil rights. According to We Are the Ship, it says, he brought our Negro League style of play to the major leagues and changed the face of baseball. He made it quicker and more daring. His base running changed the way pitchers had to pitch. Most important, Jackie cleared the way for the rest of us to play in the majors. And in doing that, helped the rest of the country closer to accepting Negroes as first-class citizens.